Welcome back to SmackDown versus Raw 2008 24/7 mode, season mode. And let's read this headline here. Randy Orton and Edge to defend their brand on SmackDown. Read. Randy Orton says that the following sneak attack he recently suffered, and you guys can finish reading that. And then you can read the little end in there, because I don't read those. They're a little too long. They just take up too much time in the video. But glad you saw the light. What is this about?
Congratulations for being smart enough to stick with Raw, champ. I can't wait to see you dish out.
Oh,
some
I can't either,
SmackDown
coach.
This week, but be careful. We can't afford for our champion to get injured this close to
SummerSlam. I won't get injured unless that's going to be a storyline where they get me injured so I can't even defend my championship and then they just give it back to fucking ass Cena there. Let's see, what's my health report anyway? My fatigue level. Damn it, I'm going to need to take some rest. Superstar info, what's my popularity at? Damn it, I can't even afford it because I need to get back on the Power 25 because I believe it's judged by popularity, and it can't be judged by popularity. I know I got a comment on that in the last one when I was complaining about why I'm not on top, but Batista wouldn't be popular, would he? I know that's not how the popularity technically goes in this game. I know that it doesn't go by how popular you should be, whether you're heel or face. It goes by, I guess, the level, and you could be a heel and have like 100, but I don't understand. No, I don't want to be on this match. I want to just be on the Power 25. That's the only thing. I don't understand how I was on top then. There's no way my popularity was higher here than it is now. But I digress on that. So I still want to get where is it? One of these, where the 5-star pay-per-view match ratings. How? What? I don't know exactly what you have to do to get a 5-star match. Is there anything you actually have to do? Or is it just if it's like a really good match? Does it have to be like a long match? Or can it just be like a short 5-minute match but still be a 5-star rating? If any of you guys know, let me know. Because I want to be able to get this one at the SummerSlam pay-per-view. So I haven't had any defenses yet. I haven't had to sign anything like that. But what's this mean? Win slash defend the title at each of the following pay-per-views: SummerSlam, Survivor Series, Royal Rumble, and WrestleMania. I will definitely try to do that. Well, so hopefully I don't lose it. Alright, now we're at ECW. Let's do I gotta take the rest. My fatigue was high as hell. I can't take the risk of pretty much dying in the ring. Alright, I wouldn't die, but it would be close. What gets me some good? Let's do a trophy day. What do we get from a trophy day? We get 5 fan popularity. Ooh, we got a message. I like these. Who's it from? Oh, we got 2. Oh, we got long. Alright, Playa. Deep down, I know you regret not jumping to SmackDown. But just in case you don't, I have a couple of guys who gonna make you. If you and Odin want to come to SmackDown, this gonna, oh my, it is too. For a fight, you gonna meet Batista and Finley in a no DQ tag team match. Because I love my tag team matches. Alright, Playa. Playas. That's it. He don't care. Tough luck. 10 long. Playa. 2. Love how he makes tag team matches. You're asking for it.
I can't believe you're actually dumb enough to come to SmackDown this week. And you and your power are going to find out the hard way that Raw's not the only brand whose superstars can show a little solidarity.
Alright, Batista. I'm pretty sure you guys are going to get your little asses beat on your little brand that you got going on there called SmackDown. You're not going to be able to beat me. You guys understand that? If I was you, I'd try as hard as I can to get out of the match because Edge and Randy Orton are just going to come over there and sweep the floor with you fucks. Let's have a pay-per-view commercial. What do we get from this? We get some cash and some fatigue. Alright, let's go to SmackDown now that we actually have to compete here. Oh, they actually booked Finlay twice. What a bunch of dumb shits. I'm ready for this. Get right into this no DQ tag team tornado match. Of course it's going to be tag team. It's made by Teddy Long. It's on SmackDown. But Playa, Teddy Long is always the fucking tag team matches.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome
yeah,
to
fuck
SmackDown.
We're not watching your little... Those backstage segments are the same thing all the time. There's no fucking point in watching them. And I'm not going to comment on what I think of Bobby Lashley, as I've done that like 3 times in past ones. Show me some new fucking loading screens, please, so I don't have to look at Bobby Lashley and fucking Triple H all the time. Oh.
My name is
and I love the fight.
This Raw invasion of SmackDown. And you couldn't ask for a much better...
Is that JBL? Aw, oh, JBL's on commentary. Aw, oh, yeah. It could be much better, though. It could be that man that they have that five time. Do you see the champion over there? If he was on commentary, man, this game would be like a Fate 5 fail fucker. It'd be like 2 feet, 3 feet, 5. Yeah, man, my Fate 5. Fucking Booker T in my Fate 5. I got Rowdy Piper in my Fate 5. He's Slater's in my Fate 5. Got them all in my Fate 5. Like, I don't even got a Fate 5. I got like a Fate 2, 300. You know, they all in my Fate 5. Like, I can't even limit it down to 5. You got fucking Tony Schimmel in there. He even in my Fate 5. Like, I don't discriminate against your race. I don't discriminate against your size. I don't discriminate against your age. I just put everyone in my Fate 5 because I just am that man. Michael Cole ain't in my Fate 5. He's like my Fate worst 5. Like, he ain't my bad 5. You know, the one that I just want to take out to that back and just kick their ass a little bit with my foot and just fuck them up a little bit there. That's Michael Cole. And Jerry Lawler, he can just eat an ass. But, you know, nobody don't like that, me, you know. Because I'm Booker T. I ain't doing a good Booker T impression, but I'm still Randy Orton coming out now there. You just see that, man, my Fate 5.
Ooh. Whose side are you on here
towards the
anyway,
end, I couldn't
Michael?
Do it. My fucking throat. Let me get a drink here. That shit dries out your throat quick. Doing a Booker T impression. Ooh.
That man right there, he my Fate 5.
We still got Raw after this too, don't we? Did we get the night off on Raw? This is going to be a long video. This is going to be like a 20-30 minute one.
But he's putting brand loyalty above personal gain. And that's all well and good.
Ooh, a spin-art title.
Would make the championship.
Oh, yeah.
Number one.
All right, let's stop it. Stop it, Edge. All right, I can't see it, but is it stopped yet? So I'm just going to spin it little by little just to make it more interesting. I wish you could spin it both ways.
That'd just make things cool. From Yonkers, New York. Debut in 1989. Hardcore champion. ECW tag. ECW champion. La da 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 da. Just 30 years later, lost the title to controversial fashion to Just Incredible. Oh no! Randy! You got in
that
my way.
Might stop his opponent's momentum dead.
Yeah, because Randy got there. In my way and just made me attack him, and I don't think I wanted to do that. Do you think I wanted to do that, Michael? Do you? Oh, it's Jeff! Like, I know he's coming here to save me, right? Or not to attack me.
He's building up ahead,
right?
Steve, and he's about to let
I believe so. I don't know what he's doing here, but.
Is smart, he'll get the hell out of there.
Let's do the airplane spin. I just wanted to do a short one, but I still wanted to do it. Regardless, I wanted to do one. Oh, what's he doing? What the hell are you doing, dude? Jeff, what the hell are you doing?
There's no doubt that these fans love him, and he's feeding off that.
Jeff, what the hell are you doing? Are you switching brands? Are you serious? You don't switch brands like that. It's just. You gotta keep brand loyalty.
Fans, you should really keep.
Do you not understand that? This is fucked up, Jeff.
Yeah,
fuck too. Jeff can go I don't know if you're even talking about him coming out here. I don't think you are, because they probably didn't program that into the game. But I don't even care. I need a chair. I need something. I need the barbed wire. Here, I'm going to grab that barbed wire piece of fuck ass from under the ring. Come here. Get the hell up, Finley. If you love the fight, you'd get your ass off the mat. Get up and let me take you out. There's no shillelagh, unfortunately. I want the shillelagh. Come on. Get up. Come here. Look at that. You're going to get this rubbed across your damn head. There should be so much blood right now that he'd just be fucking... Oh, he is bleeding. All right. That doesn't always happen, I don't believe, because I've done it before and it didn't, but I'm not going to complain. Let's give him another finisher, the second one of the match, but I'm not ending this yet. Because I can't, because Batista's still in here and all, but... Let's grab ourselves... Oh, no. Jeff's going to try to get me. That's why I'm going to get right back in the ring after grabbing the sledge. Bam!
He's swinging for the
Bam!
With that sledgehammer.
Oh, come here.
He's all about bringing the hammer down.
Come here, Batista.
You know, there's such a thing as
I did just call him Batista.
Much, and that's what I'm seeing here.
Come here.
I disagree. He's wrestled this match his way all along, and now we see it paying off.
Come here, Batista. Let's give him that. No, I was going to try to give him that DDT. Didn't work out my way. All right, let's give him this then. I didn't see the RKO. Must have missed it. I wasn't really paying attention too much.
His opponent is groggy, and he's making the
BAM! Execution.
Big move. This could be
oh,
big.
It's gonna be real big.
Quit showing off. This is a wrestling. He's climbing the turbine.
You're right, it is a wrestling match, JBL. And I'd be damned if they didn't show off and just tried to be little fuckers and just did two, three things. And so fuck you, JBL. Come here, buddy. Come here, Batista. I don't know what's going on out there, but I think I must be like weak as hell or something. Because I can barely pick him. Pick him up, not pick him. I don't know what I was saying there, but I can barely even pick the man up right now. So I must be really weak. Oh, Batista, fuck you. Oh, I can pick him up with this, but I couldn't pick him up with the other move? Are you serious? Ooh. Spear from here, or did I have to do a... Let's just give him an executioner.
Oh,
I've been through playing around. Or, I'll take care of him quickly so you can give him that... RKO. You better be able to get up and give someone the RKO. Give him the RKO, Orton. Give him the RKO.
Have you ever seen a superstar like Batista?
Orton, you didn't give him the RKO. You're a jackass. You're a piece of fucking shit is what you are, Orton. And I'm getting back in this ring after I grab a chair, that is. We gotta use the chair, but Jeff's not gonna get me. Oh, low blow by Orton. That was a great move by Orton. I enjoyed every fucking minute of it. Ooh! He just shit the bed with that one. Holy fuck, he screwed his over. Him over. Come here. Fuck you, Batista. Spear time, spear time, it's spear time. Oh my. This is done. Booker T don't even know what I say about this spear. He just gonna get it done. See, Booker T knows what he's talking about. Fuck God, it's a slobber knocker, Booker T and Justin. He don't even know. Three count, he's done. That was an ending right there. I enjoyed that ending. Jeff Hardy thought he was going to be all Mr. Badass and get in there and try to give me that breaking up. That if he had a quicker like kick and not that flipping leg drop, dude, he would have got me, but thank God.
Put up more of a fight than I expected.
Raw's fucking the superior brand.
Anything in the tank for SummerSlam.
SummerSlam is like 3 weeks away. There's plenty in the tank for SummerSlam.
I can't wait to see what happens at SummerSlam.
You gotta wait for three more fucking weeks until SummerSlam, so get the hell over it. If not more, I believe it's only three though. If we're lucky, it's only three, but... Six foot four and 245 pounds. I love how they had to use Finley twice. They must have the shittiest roster. Confirm. Where are we? We still got to do Monday, too. We still got to do Raw. Got any messages yet? Really? Wow. Do we have the night off? I don't want to, because I want to give you guys a good quality, longer video for this one. Since, you know. But I can't do anything about it if we're not booked on today's show. Oh, I guess we're not booked on the show. Damn it. That sucks. Alright, like usual, after Raw, I always end up ending the episode, so if you guys stayed through this one to the end, I thank you. Leave some feedback, leave some comments, leave whatever you want to leave down there. Leave some likes, you know, if you want to, it's your choice. If you're not subscribed yet, please subscribe. I would very much appreciate it. And I just want to thank you all for taking your time and watching this this video right here, this SmackDown vs. Raw 2008 24/7 mode. Because this game, it doesn't seem like it's fun, but I'm having a damn good time. Some people consider this to be one of the worst SmackDown vs. Raws. I say it's better than 2009, 2010. So with that being said, yet again, I'm going to thank you all for watching. And I'm going to end it on that and say I will see you guys next time when we continue this.